Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are covering here question number 241 to 60. This is the part 14th of top 400 MCQ of Code of Criminal Procedure. If you like this video, please click on like button and please subscribe our channel and share this video to your friend and relatives. Now question number 241. Order of issuance of process against the accused in complaint case under section 204 of CRPC by magistrate. So option A here can be a review by the court issuing the summon. Option B cannot be reviewed by the magistrate, as under CRPC the magistrate has no power of review. Option C can only be revised by the court of session or high court. Option D, both B and C are correct. So in this question, the order of issuance of process. So order of issuing process means the issuance of summon and warrant. So against the accused in the complaint case under section 204 of CRPC by the magistrate can be reviewed by the court issuing such summon. So answer is here option A. It can be reviewed by the who issues the issue process. Now question number 242. After dismissal of complaint under section 203, so first of all important point here, 203 of CRPC is provided that the procedure of dismissal of complaint in the fresh similar complaint on the same fact, option A is banned if the complaint is instituted in the court and such complaint is dismissal by the court, and again the institute a same facts on the basis of complaint. So which provision is applicable in this condition? First, second complaint is banned, is not banned, but it not banned, but will be entertained only in the exceptional circumstances. In not banned and will be entertained in all circumstances. And option D here, either A or C. In this question, the most favorable answer is here option B, is not banned. So first of all, second complaint is not banned, but will be entertained only. So it is only entertained in exceptional circumstances. If the facts of second complaint is same as a first complaint, so such complaint is not banned, but it is only entertained where in special and exceptional circumstance. Now question number 243, the committal proceeding under section 209. So first of all, the 209 provided the committal proceeding of CRPC are in the nature of, first option A here, add in investigation, option B inquiry, option C trial, option D either inquiry or trial. So it is clear that here it is the inquiry where the magistrate, committal magistrate is there. The section 209 provided the provision of committal magistrate in which delivered the case to the session court. So it is here option B correct here, inquiry. This proceeding is under section 209 is inquiry, and this is the here. Now question number 244, the jurisdiction to grant bail under section 438 of CRPC vested with. So first of all, which provision is provided under section 438 is provided that anticipatory provision of anticipatory bail. So it is here anticipatory bail. दिस बेल इज एप्लीकेबल बट इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल इन यूपी सिंस 8 November. सो एंटीसिपेटरी बेल इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल इन यूपी सिंस 8 November 1976. बट नाउ इन योगी गवर्नमेंट चीफ मिनिस्टर योगी आदित्यनाथ दिस प्रोविजन इज रिमूव्ड एंड नाउ एंटीसिपेटरी बेल इज ऑल्सो एप्लीकेबल इन यूपी. सो वट इज द प्रोविजन ऑफ सेक्शन 438 हियर. सो इट इज द प्रोवाइडेड डायरेक्शन टू ग्रांट एंटीसिपेटरी बेल और विच पर्सन हैविंग द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ एंटीसिपेटरी बेल अ पर्सन इज हु कमिटिंग नॉन बेलेबल ऑफेंस. फर्स्ट पॉइंट हियर नॉन बेलेबल ऑफेंस एंड सेकेंड इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज ही हैज़ द एप्रीहेंशन ऑफ अरेस्ट. सो सच पर्सन इज हैविंग एप्रीहेंशन देयर इज अ डाउट दैट ही विल बी अरेस्टेड दैट्स वाई ही इंस्टीट्यूट द एप्लीकेशन फॉर एंटीसिपेटरी बेल. सो दिस प्रोविजन इज एंटीसिपेटरी अंडर सेक्शन 438 एंटीसिपेटरी बेल. Now question number here, option A here, the court of magistrate, option B session court of session, option C high court, option D session court and high court, not in the court of magistrate. So here answer is option D. And the power of giving the granting anticipatory bail is to the session court and high court, not to the court to magistrate. Now question number 245 under section 436 of CRPC the bail can be granted by police officer, magistrate, police as well as magistrate, by magistrate only, not the police. So in this question the both having the power police officer. So in the section the word using the officer, so police officer and court like magistrate, so both persons having a power to grant a bail under section 436. So option B is correct here. Now question number 246. The person who granting bail under section 436 failed to comply with a condition of time and place of attendance on a subsequent occasion. So when the magistrate giving a bail under section 436 and he introduces some condition. First of all, important point is conditions only available in non-bailable offense. So these condition only available in non-bailable offense, not in bailable offense. Bailable offense is a right of bail, so there is no condition. But in non-bailable offense, there is a condition. So if any person who is the court introduce a condition and such person of condition like to present in further occasion, but such person is not present before the court, in so what provision is there against the entitled to bail as a matter of right is not entitled to bail as a matter of right. So first here entitled here and second one not entitled. Now option 3 here the court may refuse to release him on bail. Option D here both B and C. So in this question answer is here option B and C, not entitled to bail as a right if the person is not comply the condition to present before a court in particular time or place. So he has not a right to bail. And second here the court may refuse to release him on bail. So option D is correct here. Now question number 247 under section 437 of CRPC. Know a mere fact that the accused person may be required for being identified by the witness during the investigation. Option A here, the bail can be refused. Bail cannot be refused. Option C here, the bail should be refused. Bail can be and should be refused. So this is very important question here.
under section 437, the mere the fact that the accused person may required, very important point here, may require for being identified by witness. Here accused is required for identify by the witness during investigation. First of all, it is not a ground to refuse the bail of accused. So this is very important point. So according to section 437, this is not a ground, it is not a sufficient ground, it is not sufficient ground for refusing to grant bail. So if the witness accused is required to identify by the witness, so this is not a ground to refusing the bail according to the proviso. This thing is provided under the proviso of section 437 proviso. So according to this proviso, answer is here, the bail cannot be refused because it is not a sufficient ground to reject his bail. Now question number 248. In non-bailable offence, the trial by a magistrate application for bail under section 437 of CRPC can be removed before the court. So first important point here, the magistrate competent to try and entertain the case, option B, the chief judicial magistrate and or additional chief judicial magistrate. So these two magistrate, chief judicial magistrate and additional chief judicial magistrate, both having the same power. Now option C here, court of session. Option D here, only A and C. So in this question, answer is here option D, only A and C. So first of all, competent magistrate and option C here, session court. Now question number 249. The condition on the release of bail can be imposed. I already expressed these things. The condition on the release on bail can be imposed in bailable offense, all non-bailable offense. In non-bailable offense, punishable with imprisonment may extend to 7 years or more. Option D here, only in B and C. So here answer is option D, only B and C, because the condition is not imposed in offense related to the bailable, because in bailable offense the accused having the right to bail, and in non-bailable the court having the discretion to grant a bail. So these two options, B and C, is correct here. So answer D. Now question number 250. Any condition imposed by magistrate while releasing the accused in a non-bailable offense, the case can be set aside or modified. So option A here, magistrate himself. Option B, by court of session. Option C here, high court. And option D, all of the above. So in this question, the condition imposed, first of all, condition is imposed by the magistrate by releasing the accused. So in one, which offense? In non-bailable offense, can be set aside. So who can set aside or modify? The same magistrate who give the bail on condition. And second one here, session court may set aside the order and modify. And third one is high court. All these courts having the power to. So answer is here option D. Now question number 251. Under section 439 of CRPC, the jurisdiction to cancel the bail vested with court of session, high court, court of magistrate, only A and B. So here answer is again option D, A and B. The court of session and high court can cancel the bail. Now question number question number 252. Under section 437 of CRPC, the jurisdiction to cancel the bail vested with. So it is clear here 437 of CRPC, provided that when the bail may be taken in the case of non-bailable offence, and such non-bailable offence is the bail is granting on the condition if such person is not follow the condition. So the following courts are, the giving courts are cancel such bail. So option A here, magistrate competent to try and entertain the bail. So this magistrate competent to try and entertain the bail can cancel such bail. Option B, the magistrate where the magistrate has not ordered to release on bail. Option C, magistrate only where the magistrate has ordered the release on bail. Option D, all of the above. So here answer is option C, the magistrate only where the magistrate has ordered to release on bail. Now question number 253, in the case of non-bailable offence, the bail granted by magistrate can be cancelled under section 437 subsection 5 of CRPC. Option A here, magistrate granting the bail. So here magistrate who granting a bail. Option B here, court of session. Option C here, high court. Option D here, all of the court. So in this question, the word used under section 437 subsection 5 is any court. Any court word is used here. So any court including high court, session court, and magistrate, and who granting bail. So here answer is option D, all of the above. Now question number 54. The bail amount fixed by a magistrate can be, option A, reduced by the magistrate. Option B, reduced by court of session. Option C, reduced by high court. Option D here, only B and C. So here answer is only B and C, reduced by court of session and reduced by high court. So again I read here question, the bail amount fixed by magistrate can be reduced, not reduced by the same magistrate, it is reduced by the session court and high court. That's why answer is here option D. Now question number 255, the section 438 of CRPC can be invoked. Option A, case of non-bailable offence. Option B, case of bailable offence. Option C, both A and B. Option D, neither A nor B. So here answer is option A, non-bailable offence. So which thing is provided under section 438? Anticipatory bail. So anticipatory bail, the person who has the apprehension of arrest, in the case of non-bailable, he may institute application for anticipatory bail in high court or session court. That's why option is here, option A, he is correct, non-bailable offence. Now question number 256, the cash in lieu of surety bond can be permitted by virtue of, option A, 441 of CRPC. Option B here, section 442 of CRPC. Option C here, section 445 of CRPC. Option D here, section 444 of CRPC. So here answer is option C, section 445 of CRPC. So 445 is provided here. The deposit instead of recognized. Recognizance, this thing is provided under section 445. So now question number 257, for non-payment and non-recovery of penalty from surety under the surety bond, the surety can be sentenced to. It is very important question, many time asked in many exams like UP, Jharkhand, Rajasthan, Uttarakhand. Option A here, simply imprisoned only. ऑप्शन बी रिगरस इम्प्रिजनमेंट ओनली एंड ऑप्शन सी सिविल इम्प्रिजनमेंट ओनली एंड ऑप्शन डी हियर आइदर ए बी सी. सो इट इज़ क्लियर हियर आंसर इज सिविल इम्प्रिजनमेंट ओनली. फॉर अ नॉन पेमेंट और नॉन रिकवरी ऑफ पेनाल्टी फ्रॉम द सियोरिटी अंडर द सियोरिटी बॉन्ड द सियोरिटी कैन बी सेंटेंस इन सिविल इम्प्रिजनमेंट. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 258. द सियोरिटी कैन बी सेंटेंस टू सिविल इम्प्रिजनमेंट इन डिफॉल्ट ऑफ पेमेंट ऑफ पेनाल्टी अंडर द सियोरिटी बॉन्ड फॉर मैक्सिमम पीरियड. ऑप्शन ए 6 मंथ, ऑप्शन बी 3 मंथ, ऑप्शन सी 2 मंथ, ऑप्शन ए 1 मंथ. सो इट इज क्लियर हेयर ऑप्शन ए 6 मंथ. तो सियोरिटी इज इम्प्रिजन फॉर 6 मंथ फॉर द नॉन पेमेंट ऑफ पेनाल्टी. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 259. द पेनाल्टी अंडर सियोरिटी बॉन्ड कैन नॉट बी रिमिटेड कैन बी रिमिटेड इन फुल. ऑप्शन सी हियर कैन बी रिमिटेड इन पार्ट ओनली. ऑप्शन डी हियर कैन बी रिमिटेड इन फुल और इन पार्ट. सो द पेनाल्टी अंडर द सियोरिटी बॉन्ड इज रिमिटेड इन फुल और पार्ट. सो आंसर इज हियर ऑप्शन डी. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 260 फाइनल क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस वीडियो. द प्रिपोजिशन एज रिगार्ड द लाइबिलिटी ऑफ सियोरिटी अंडर द सियोरिटी बॉन्ड्स आर. ऑप्शन हियर पॉइंट नंबर 1 द लाइबिलिटी ऑफ सियोरिटी इज म्यूचुअली एक्सक्लूसिव ऑफ लाइबिलिटी ऑफ द एक्यूज अंडर हीज पर्सनल बॉन्ड. ऑप्शन पॉइंट 2 हियर लाइबिलिटी. सो इट इज क्लियर हियर करेक्ट ऑप्शन करेक्ट पॉइंट हियर. नाउ पॉइंट नंबर 2 द लाइबिलिटी ऑफ सियोरिटी इज कंटीजेंट ऑन द लाइबिलिटी ऑफ एक्यूज अंडर हीज पर्सनल बॉन्ड द लाइबिलिटी ऑफ सियोरिटी. पॉइंट नंबर 3 हियर इज लिमिटेड टू द अमाउंट ऑफ सियोरिटी बॉन्ड. सो दिस पॉइंट इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट हियर. सो फर्स्ट पॉइंट एंड सेकेंड पॉइंट हियर करेक्ट हियर. So here answer is option B is correct. Sorry, first and third. So option A is correct. Option A is correct. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please click on like button and subscribe our channel. Thank you.